Good morning and welcome to Knollwood United Methodist Church. I'm Reverend Kalesita U Tu'ifua, and I'm so glad that you join all of us to worship together. This is our home church. Yes, this is Knollwood United Methodist Church. And I appreciate it of your support, your prayers, your love, and being there with your faith and your hope and your love for God and love for neighbors. And I wanted to welcome each and every one of you to our first Sunday of September 2020. This is our online service this morning, and we'll be having our Holy Communion. I hope you prepared your table, that we partake the body and the blood of Christ. I hope that you find our worship today a time of blessing to you and your family. Even though we come from our own unique places and separate path, calling by name, together, seeking God's love, hear God's word, and allow God's spirit to guide us as we allow our lives to be transformed, so together we might grow and serve effectively from this place, from your place in this world. Here is the link of our website where you can go and learn more about our congregation. Also our Facebook page where you get to see today's service and also the previous services that we have been. And also our YouTube link where you can enjoy our previous services if you missed any of our services since this pandemic.
My name is Ofina Tuihawaka, and I'm glad to be one of your liturgists today on this first Sunday of September. We are so glad for you to join us during this worship. So let us prepare our mind, heart, spirit to worship and give thanks to God with grateful heart, with our call to worship. Please join me in the call to worship. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come into his presence with singing. Know that the Lord, he is God. It is he who made us, and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him, bless his name, for the Lord is good. His steadfast love endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations. Please join me in the first hymn, number 139, Praise to the Lord, the Almighty.
Thank you. join me in the opening prayer. O Lord, we come before you this morning with praise and thanksgiving. Open our minds to what you have to teach us. Open our hearts to your love and enable us to love you in a new and profound way. Open our souls to the joy that can only be found in you. In Christ's holy name we pray. Amen. Please join me with the affirmation of faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, buried, and on the third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and was seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From then he shall come and judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Great with your study, with our prayers and our support. There are rules that you must follow. I know when you're in school, you have rules, right?
Yes.
That the teacher usually write it on the board. What are those rules?
To not talk when someone's talking.
Yes, not talking when somebody's talking. Okay, what else?
Listen closely because they might ask questions later.
Okay, what else?
And respect when people are talking.
Okay, that's right. When you're standing in line, wait patiently. Don't run down the hallway. Wash your hands before you eat. Treat each other nice.
No.
Be kind. No. Respect. I'm sure at home, your parents probably set some rules. Focus on your study. Stop talking while you're doing your work. You may distract each other.
Stop playing around.
Always wash your hand. Don't play around. Be honest. Wear your mask when you go out to the public, right?
Yeah.
Listen to mom. Whatever rules that you said, mute your device during Zoom, and you only unmute when you're ready to talk, right? Raise your hand before you speak. So those are the rules, and you must follow those rules because those rules has a function and a purpose. Every rule's set for your own good. Those rules help you safe from coronavirus. Those rules make you a better learner and be able to focus on your study. Today in our reading, look into Romans chapter 13, verse 8 to 14. Paul writes this letter to the Christians in Rome, telling them, love one another. Owe nothing but
love.
And for such a time as this, it's so hard to love one another, right? But if you respond with love, because God loves you, you know that God loves you and God wants you to love one another because God sent his son, Jesus Christ. And because God loves you, you can do anything with God. Amen?
Amen.
So let us pray for all our children. Okay, Fanga Lupe?
Okay.
God, we thank you for loving us, despite of trials and tribulation and what's happening in our world. We pray that you be with our children as they study from home. Encourage and empower with your Holy Spirit. Provide them with their needs. And may your wisdom and understanding guide their mind and their lives, so they know how much you love them, so they may love one another and respond in godly ways as the best way to live our life now during this COVID-19. Bless our children and continue to be with them throughout this school year. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Pastor prayer for this morning. I have two of our church members sharing their joy and their blessings, and I'm sure that you love to hear from them as well. And we'll pray together.
Good evening. This is my lovely mother, Martha Rucker, who was born January 4th, 1926.
Hi, everybody. As I sit here trying to figure out what all I can leave out about these past months, I'm mindful of the concern that I've had through the whole pandemic so far. As my heart goes out to those who got the COVID-D, not me sitting here in the comfort of a lovely home and not having anybody come near, and Debbie's guarding me like a watchdog. So I don't have any experience in seeing around me any of the panic that must go on in this part of the valley. I've been out about maybe three or four times most over a period. And then they've been to doctor's or dentist appointments and all that kind of stuff. So I sit and I do a lot of reading. I go to bed late. I'm a night hawk, and of course I sleep late in the morning as well. But I'm getting in the habit of setting my alarm and trying to get up by 10 o'clock, so my whole day really isn't wasted sleeping. But I'm blessed by the Lord that I can sleep well, and I do. I sleep from the time I go to bed to the time I get up. Picking a hymn was difficult for me, because I lovingly say my favorite hymn is the hymn I'm singing in church at the time. But when I went through the book, I there's so many lovely hymns that I like, but I think the one that strikes me in is, I like the hymns that are uplifting, that make you feel good. And I think that the hymn on page 364 is Because He Lives. And I really like that. I sit down in the second row in the sanctuary, and I've sat in the front row or second row my whole adult life. And the reason I sit down there primarily is that when I sing a hymn, I can just belt it out, and it doesn't matter if anybody can hear me or if side by side. Years ago, when I had one of my kids on each side of me singing, they would take, as soon as the hymn started, they would take one step away from me. And we laugh, I laugh about that when I sing. And I'm glad that I'm able to sing, because after I had the stroke a couple years ago, it didn't occur to me that I couldn't sing. And so when I went to the church the first time after I went to sing, not a note. And it's getting better, but I won't be able to sing a solo very soon. Anyhow, that's one of my favorite hymns is He Lifts Me Up.
What? Because He Lives.
Because He Lives. I think everybody knows it. I'm not going to try to sing it, but I'd be glad to if we didn't have a sound going. I can belt it away. But I daily lift up people who have the COVID virus and who are ill. And I'm always having the Lord send bands of angels to everybody to surround them, especially if they don't feel well. And I think it's easy for me. I have no difficulty being by myself. Deborah, of course, is here too. Not always, but I do fine alone. I just have my walker, and she sets me up with things I need. And I do well, and I'm also blessed that when I'm sitting in my chair, I can look out the patio, and I can see the green leaves, and I can see some of the tops of cars going by, and an occasional person will walk by.
And a hummingbird.
And a hummingbird, yeah, they fly in and out. So I'm doing very well. And there's no reason why I can't, because I really don't do anything but get up and come up. I come upstairs to have dinner with Deborah, but not maybe once or twice a week. I don't venture up the stairs because I'm blessed also that I have some speed. I laughingly say I have two speeds, slow and stop, but God has been good to me. I'm glad to do this for my church and for my church family, and I don't have much more to say about the COVID since I don't know anybody who has it, and I do watch the news, and I watch especially that we should wear a mask, and I've done that when we've gone out. And I have a really good smile. Recently, in the last couple of weeks, I went to my dentist and I got all new teeth, some new teeth on the bottom. So I got rid of my wobbly ones. God has been good to me. And I will have to close and say I miss you all. And God bless you.
Hello, everybody. I have Connie Rusafi here with me. I come to visit her and her daughter, and we're recording a message from her and for you guys to see how she's doing, and here she is. Hello, Connie.
Hello, Kalesita and the church. I appreciate this. We all go through difficult times in our life, but Nick's passing was so quick, and I hardly had a chance to say anything to him, but in my heart, I know he's with me. I'm doing okay after a few days in the hospital. I've found that his boys and my girls are so supportive, except that they gang up on me sometimes. I miss the church. I wish all of you are safe and well, and I hope to be back soon. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you.
Scripture for today comes from Romans chapter 13, verses 8 to 14. owe no one anything except to love one another, for he who loves another has fulfilled the law. For the commandments, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not murder, you shall not steal, you shall not bear false witness, you shall not covet, and if there is any other commandment, all are summed up in saying this, namely, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. Love does no harm to a neighbor, therefore love is the fulfillment of the law. And do this, knowing the time, that now is a high time to awake out of sleep. For now our salvation is near, when we were first believed. The night is far spent, the day is at hand. Therefore, let us cast off all the works of darkness, and let us put the armor of light. Let us walk properly as in the day, and not in revelry and drunkenness. Not in the lewdness and the lust, not in strife and envy. But put the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision for the flesh to fulfill its lust. This is the word of God.
Thanks be to God.
My message comes from Romans chapter 13, verse 8 to 14. Paul is calling all Christians in Rome. Despite of suffering under slavery, as the Roman government put heavy tax and burdens on Christians, Paul called them, owe them nothing but love. Bring it closer to where we are right now. We're facing pandemic. We've been isolated for almost 6 months now. I thought by September we should be back here and worship on Sunday morning, but it didn't happen. But I know that we all agree it's better to be saved than sorry. So from the security and safe of your home, let us hear what Paul's saying that may encourage and empower us to see how can we face trials and tribulations of COVID-19. How can we live now as Christians? In verse 8, Paul started off by saying, owe nothing but love. Love your neighbors as you love yourself. Paul is reminding us what Jesus said as he put together all the commandments from the Old Testament. And Jesus said, to fulfill all the commandments and the law of God, you love God with all your hearts, your minds, your strength, and love your neighbors as you love yourself. Who is your neighbor? Not only those who live next to you or around your community. Your neighbor is those who you encounter. Those who are in need and you need to help them. Love them with everything that you have. When we read in the book, in the letters to the Romans, Paul started off Romans 1 to chapter 11 and talked about how God's grace and mercy saved the world from sin. Talks about God's redemption. And when come to chapter 12, Paul says, now you have been saved from sin. Live as a living sacrifice. Offer yourselves to God by renewing your mind and transforms your heart. And how do we live as a living sacrifice? Remember in the Old Testament, Moses called the Israelites to offer their best. Bring a dead animal as a sacrifice and offer to God with thanksgiving. But here Paul is calling us, offer yourselves as a living sacrifice, because we have the blessing, the breath of life, to offer ourselves with the opportunity and the life that we have as of today, as a living person. Give thanks to God with your voices, with your talents, with your gift, with your wealth, everything that you have. Offer as a living sacrifice, which means that we give up ourselves, denied ourselves, but offer ourselves for the glory of God. And here Paul continued to talk about how we live as a transformed person, as a Christian. Remember in Rome, there are two types of Christians, the Jewish Christians and the Gentile Christians. And they try to live together as Christians who believe Jesus Christ, who died and rose again. Even though they came from different cultures, context. They came at the different times to understand the gospel and convert and repent and become a Christian. And on top of that, they have been treated as slaves under the Roman government. But Paul said to them, as a Christian, as a true Christian, you must love one another. Love your enemies. Rephrasing what Jesus' Sermon on the Mount, Matthew 5:44, Jesus gave his disciples a clear set of instruction about responding to those who make their life miserable. Love your enemies. Bless those who curse you. Do good to those who hate you. Pray for those who despitefully use you and persecute you. This is the way you respond to overcome evil with good. How do we respond and live now as Christians during this political seasons? And many of us have all different agenda, and we see things differently in our government, and we put in a group that we see each other as enemies, or maybe not in the same agreement with, and we make judgment of each other. We're in a time that we have seen our nation has been divided by racism, and we hate this particular group, or we with this particular group. All these things is happening in our world. How can we live as Christians? Paul is calling us, love one another. Why? Because God loves you. He sent his son, Jesus Christ. And throughout the gospel, you can read through how God loves the world, his redemption, his greatest gift of sending his only begotten son. Because you know why? When we love one another, despite of the circumstances, despite of what's happening in our world, we give it the glory and the honor to God. When we love, we have no time to make judgments against other people. When we have love, that means we have accepted God's grace. And when we react with love, it brings joy. It makes a difference, and it transforms other people's life. With love, we know that we belong to God. Ephesians 6:17 describes the word of God, that the sword of the Spirit, it's very powerful. The only offensive weapon in our spiritual armor, Jesus said, is the word that I speak unto you. They are spirit and they are life. And they have the authority that can claim the promise of God. So if we abide in Christ and abide in God's word, whatever we ask, whatever we do, God will provide. God's spirit will help you, strengthen you. So whenever things happened here right now, we shall overcome because God's grace and God's word and God's love is with us. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Water and the Spirit, on the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took the bread and gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so in remembrance of this, your mighty act in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. For we all partake of the one loaf, the bread, which is break, is a sharing in the body of Christ. The cup over which we give thanks is a sharing in the blood of Christ. Let us give thanks. And now I invite you to take this time as we gather with our family in our own homes to partake the bread, symbolize the body of Christ, and the cup, share with one another the blood of Jesus Christ that was shed for forgiveness of our sins. So now, I invite one of you to take the bread and share it with your family. And if you are alone, take the bread as I share with you. This is the body of Christ given for you. You may eat. And now this is the cup, the new covenant that you make today with God as you put your faith and trust in Jesus Christ. This is the cup of new covenant. Share with one another. Now you may take and drink with thanksgiving. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, we thank you for the mystery of your love through your Son, Jesus Christ. As we eat the bread that symbolizes the broken of your body for the world, as we drink the cup as a new covenant for those who put their faith and trust in Jesus Christ, we pray that may this bread and this cup strengthen our body, our mind, and our spirit, that we continue to go out to the world and share the love of God through Jesus Christ with our faith and trust in him. That is our covenant with you, O Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you.
Let us come to our benediction. During this trial and tribulation, during this COVID-19, you may be isolated at your home. Remember that God's grace in Jesus Christ, who came to give us life and give it to us abundantly. Continue to live your life knowing that God loves you. God is with you, with the power of the Holy Spirit surrounded you to protect you, to empower you, and encourage you. Therefore, live as Christians who believe in God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen.